In last lecture we will study what is meant by atom, fundamental particles of atom and some properties of these fundamental properties. We know that atom it is a again subdivided into three important fundamental particles, that is electrons, protons and neutrons. Now today's lecture we will discuss about discoveries of these three fundamental particles, that is discoveries of electrons, protons and neutrons. Now we see first discovery of electrons. We know that this electron, it is a negatively charged particles are present at extra nuclear part of atom, or this electrons are surrounded by nucleus in circular path. This electron, it is represented as E minus. This electrons, it is discovered by scientist J.J. Thomson in 1897. This electrons, it is discovered by scientist J.J. Thomson in 1897 by using experiment. This experiment, it is called as cathode ray tube experiment. Cathode ray tube experiment, it is also called as CRT experiment. This discovery of electron, it is discovered by scientist J.J. Thomson by using cathode ray tube experiment. Now we draw first this experimental diagram. We draw here
are migrated or deflected to
four positive magnets. Here, these cathode rays are migrate toward positive magnets. That means these cathode rays here not straight line, but here deflection occurs toward positive magnets. This is a deflected path. That means this cathode rays are produced here. This cathode, this is a negatively charged particles. This cathode rays are negatively charged particles. That means according to JJ Thomson's, this cathode ray is a stream of tiny particles. These rays are produced as cathode in, migrate cathode to anode in straight line. But after passing this hole, these cathode rays are migrated or deflected to a positive magnet. That means these cathode rays are negatively charged particles. Therefore, these negatively charged particles, after it is named as electrons. After these negatively charged particles named as electrons. This is a discovery of electrons. Now we see some characteristics property of these cathode rays. First, this cathode rays, it is a stream of tiny particles. These cathode rays are produced at cathode end and migrate cathode to anode in straight line. This is a one. Another characteristic, this cathode rays are migrating straight line. Then, this cathode rays, it is a negatively charged particles. It is called as electrons. Another characteristic property of this electrons, this mass of electron, it is a 1837 times lighter than mass of hydrogen. It is a another characteristics. Mass of this negatively charged electrons, it is a 1837 times lighter than mass of hydrogen. Now we see actually definition of electrons. This electrons, it is a fundamental particle of atom which carry one unit negative charge. And mass of this electron, it is exactly equal to mass of this electron, it is a exactly equal to 1 by 1837 times mass of hydrogen. It is a definition of electrons. This electrons, it is a fundamental particle of atom which carry one unit negative charge, and mass of this electron, it is exactly equal to 1 by 1837 times mass of hydrogen. It is a first fundamental property, electron, and there are discoveries of electrons. Now we see next discovery of protons. We know that this proton, it is a positively charged particles. These positively charged particles are present center of nucleus. These positively charged particles present at the nucleus. Now this discovery of proton, it is discovered by scientist Ernst Rutherford. In 1911. These protons, it is discovered by scientist Ernst Rutherford in 1911 by using experiment scattering of alpha particle by thin gold foil. It is called as scattering of alpha particle experiment to discover protons. These protons, it is discovered by scientist Rutherford by using experiment scattering of alpha particles. Here using alpha particles, and these alpha particles strike on gold foil, or this alpha particle bombarded on gold foil. Now we see drop first this scattering through this source. This is a lead plate. Then here this is again photographic plate. Then here this is called as gold foil. And here scintillation occur or sparking of this alpha particle on this photographic plate. It is called as scintillation. Scintillation, or it is also called as sparking. Sparking of this alpha particle. It is a experimental diagram of this scattering of alpha particle by thin gold foil. Here, by using source of alpha particle, in the source of alpha particle, some alpha particle are migrated. Then these alpha particles are strike on this lead plate, or this alpha particle are bombarded on this lead plate. After this bombarding of alpha particle on lead plate, some alpha particles are passing through lead plate and strike on this gold foil. It is a gold foil, and this alpha particle are bombarded on this gold foil. According to this experimental diagram, this Rutherford observed, few of the alpha particles are back bounced. We see here, this is a gold foil, and some alpha particles are bombarded on this gold foil. These alpha particles are migrated toward this photographic plate. That means, few alpha particles are migrating straight line. Few alpha particles are migrated less than 90 degree, few alpha particles migrated greater than 90 degree, and few alpha particles are migrated back on after streaking on this gold foil. That means few alpha particles are back deflected in 180 degree on back side. After observing this experimental diagram, experimental procedure, here this Rutherford observed few of the alpha particles back bounce on streaking of this gold foil. म्हणजे जे alpha particle gold foil वरती strike होणार आहे त्यावेळी त्यामध्ये काही alpha particle असे आहेत की ते back bounce येतात, gold foil मधून pass न होता ते काय होते आहे तसे back येतात. On this observation concluded, or on this observation, this Rutherford concluded that here presence of massive and positively charged nucleus present inside the atom. According to this scattering of alpha particle experiment, this Rutherford concluded that presence of massive and positively charged particles present inside the nucleus. It is a nucleus, and this nucleus presence of this massive and positively charged particles, and this positively charged particles, it is called as protons. These positively charged particles, it is called as protons. It is actually experimental diagram of this scattering of alpha particle by thin gold foil. Here using thin gold foil, and this alpha particles strike or bombarded on this thin gold foil. Few alpha particles are back bounced or deflected back. Therefore, this Rutherford concluded that here presence of massive, that means heavy and positively charged nucleus, presence inside the atom. This is a discovery of proton in 1911. After this observation, That means presence of massive and positively charged nucleus present inside the atom. In 1990, Rutherford found alpha particles strike on nitrogen atom or alpha particle bombarded on nitrogen. Here formation of hydrogen. Right here is alpha particle bombarded on nitrogen. Here formation of hydrogen. That means in this reaction, after bombardment of this nitrogen on alpha particle, here formation of oxygen plus hydrogen atom. That means here nuclear transmutation of nitrogen into oxygen with elimination of hydrogen atom. In this reaction, this hydrogen it is simultaneously liberated. With nitrogen it is converted into oxygen. We write here reaction nitrogen atomic number 7 mass number 14 plus alpha particle atomic number 2 mass number 4. This alpha particle it is also called as helium atom. Then we see here reaction this nitrogen strike on alpha particle or this nitrogen are bombarded on this alpha particle. Here this nitrogen it is nuclear transmutation into oxygen atom. That means here formation of oxygen atomic number 8 mass number 16 plus simultaneous liberation of hydrogen atom. Here simultaneous liberation of hydrogen atom. On this reaction this Rutherford concluded that after alpha particle sticking of any element, here always emitted hydrogen atom. After bombardment of this alpha particle or helium atom on any element, here simultaneously liberation of or always liberation of hydrogen atom. Then this hydrogen atom it is named as a proton. After this reaction, this hydrogen atom it is named as a proton. On this basis of reaction, that means nitrogen it is nuclear transmutation into oxygen with simultaneously liberation of this hydrogen atom, this Rutherford concluded that this proton, that means hydrogen atom, always present inside the nucleus. This hydrogen atom always present inside the nucleus. This hydrogen atom it is called as protons. This protons it is represented as H11, that means atomic number 1, mass number 1. This is a representation of hydrogen, representation of protons. According to this reaction, these protons always present inside the nucleus. That means according to Rutherford, this proton it is a fundamental properties of atom which carry one positive charge, which carry one unit positive charge, and mass of this proton it is nearly equal to mass of hydrogen atom. It is a discovery of proton discovered by Rutherford by using scattering of alpha particle by thin wall foil. And this Rutherford observed here one reaction, alpha particle strike on nitrogen, here simultaneously liberation of hydrogen atom. That means any element bombarded on alpha particle always emitted hydrogen atom. According to this observation, this hydrogen atom always present inside the nucleus, because this hydrogen it is called as after name proton, and this proton it is a positively charged particles. This proton it is represented as H11. On this observation, this proton it is called as proton. It is a fundamental particles of atom which carry one positive unit charge, and mass of proton it is nearly equal to mass of hydrogen. Up till point we will discuss about discoveries of electrons and discoveries of protons. Now we see third discovery of neutrons. We know that this neutron it is represented as equal here, and this neutron, it is present inside the nucleus along with proton. That means this is a nucleus, and it means here presence of both protons and neutrons. But this proton, it is a positive charged particles, and this neutron, it is a chargeless particles. Then in 1920, Rutherford predicted that presence of neutral particle inside the atom, neutral particles, that means presence of neutrons inside the nucleus on the basis of atomic mass and atomic mass number. म्हणजे 1920 मध्ये रुदरफोर्डनी न्यूट्रल पार्टिकल न्यूक्लियस मध्ये प्रेझेन्स आहेत असं सांगितलं, पण कशावरून सांगितलं? डिफरन्स बिटवीन ऍटॉमिक मास अँड देअर ऍटॉमिक नंबर. देन दी स्टोरीज ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स इन 1932 साइंटिस्ट जेम्स चॅडविक ऑब्झर्व इमिशन ऑफ high velocity unidentified neutral radiations. This Chadwick observed emission of high velocity unidentified neutral radiation after striking of alpha particle on beryllium atom. After striking of these alpha particles on beryllium atom, in this story of neutrons, this neutron, it is discovered by scientist James Chadwick observed emission of high velocity unidentified neutral radiation. म्हणजे James Chadwick ने काय ऑब्झर्व केलं, हे जे अनआयडेंटिफाईड न्यूट्रल रेडिएशन इमिट होणार आहे ते अनआयडेंटिफाईड न्यूट्रल रेडिएशन इमिट कधी होते? आफ्टर बॉम्बार्डमेंट ऑफ दिस अल्फा पार्टिकल ऑन बेरिलियम ऍटम. वी रेड फर्स्ट एक्सपेरिमेंटल डायग्राम. दिस इज अ सोर्स ऑफ अल्फा पार्टिकल अँड दिस सोर्स ऑफ अल्फा पार्टिकल इज कॉल्ड एज पोलोनियम सोर्स. देन दिस पोलोनियम सोर्स हियर अल्फा पार्टिकल इमिटेड. This is a beryllium particle. This is a paraffin. And this paraffin, here high velocity proton emitted. It is a proton. This is a alpha particles. Here attached beryllium. After alpha particle bombarded on this beryllium, here few neutral radiations are emitted, and this neutral radiation after sticking on this paraffin, neutral radiation, it is converted into protons. That means this neutral radiation is converted into positively charged particles. Here formation of unidentified neutral radiations. This is actually diagram of this discovery of neutrons. According to James Chadwick, James Chadwick observed emission of high velocity unidentified neutral radiations. The neutral radiation kuthe tayar hote? पोलोनियम सोर्स मधून जे अल्फा पार्टिकल बाहेर पडणार आहे ते अल्फा पार्टिकल कुणावरती स्ट्राइक झाले? बेरिलियम ऍटम वरती. इथून जे अल्फा पार्टिकल बेरिलियम मधून पास होणार आहे त्याचे काय तयार झालं? अनआयडेंटिफाईड न्यूट्रल रेडिएशन. दॅट मीन्स दिस रेडिएशन इट इज अ न्यूट्रली रेडिएशन. अँड आफ्टर दिस न्यूट्रल रेडिएशन स्ट्रिकिंग बॉम्बार्डेड ऑन दिस पॅराफिन, हिअर फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्रोटोनिक रेडिएशन. मीन्स दिस न्यूट्रल रेडिएशन इज कन्वर्टेड इंटू पॉझिटिव्हली चार्ज ऑफ प्रोटॉन्स रेडिएशन. नाव इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट दिस जेम चॅडविक कन्क्लुडेड दॅट name is James Chadwick, observed unidentified neutron radiations. And according to this James Chadwick, it is concluded that this unidentified neutron radiation, it have no unit charge, but mass of this neutron radiation, it is equal to mass of hydrogen atom. म्हणजे अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस एक्सपेरिमेंटल डायग्राम चार्विकच्या मध्ये अनआयडेंटिफाईड रेडिएशन जे बेरिलियम वरून बाहेर पडले ते अनआयडेंटिफाईड रेडिएशन कसे त्याच्यावरती कोणताही चार्ज नाही, म्हणजे पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज पण नाही आणि निगेटिव्ह चार्ज पण नाही, इट इज इट चार्जलेस. बट मास ऑफ दिस न्यूट्रल रेडिएशन हे कुणाबरोबर सिमिलर आहे, मास ऑफ हायड्रोजन एटम. दॅट मीन्स this neutral radiations, it is called as neutrons. These neutral radiations which have no unit charge but mass, it is similar to mass of hydrogen, this neutral radiation, it is called as neutrons. We write here reaction of this beryllium atomic number 4 mass number 9 plus this beryllium bombarded on this alpha particle. Here formation of this beryllium, it is converted into carbon with atomic number 6 and mass number 12 plus emission of neutral radiations. This neutral radiation, it is called as neutron. This neutron, it is represented as N01, means mass of neutron, it is exactly similar to mass of hydrogen atom. Plus here elimination of neutral radiation, it is actually reactions. This beryllium strike on alpha particle, here formation of neutral radiations. This neutral radiation, it is called as neutrons and represented as N01. We see another, after replacement of this beryllium by using this boron, we write here boron atomic number 5 mass number 11 plus this boron strike on this alpha particle, that means this boron bombarded on helium atom. Here also elimination of this neutral radiations. Plus here evolution of nitrogen with 714 plus emission of this neutral radiation. Observing these two reactions, this beryllium or boron atom bombarded on this alpha particle here always emit a neutral molecule. This neutral molecule, it is called as neutrons with no any charge, but mass of neutrons, it is exactly equal to mass of hydrogen atom. That means definition of neutron, it is a neutron, it is also fundamental particle of atom which carry no any charge, but mass of neutron, it is exactly equal to mass of hydrogen atoms. It is a three discovery of fundamental particles, that is discovery of electron, protons and neutrons. First electron, it is discovered by scientist J.J. Thomson by using cathode ray tube experiment. Second discovery of protons, it is discovered by scientist Ernst Rutherford by using scattering of alpha particles by gold foil experiment. And third discovery of neutrons, it is discovered by scientist James Chadwick by observation this beryllium or boron strike on alpha particle, formation of or emission of neutral unidentified radiations, it is called as neutrons. So today's lecture we will discuss about discoveries of these three fundamental particles.